I'm going to discuss the Scatchard plot. A Scatchard plot is used to quantify the binding affinity of receptor to its substrate. So it resembles the Michaelis-Menten plot given for enzyme-substrate interaction. Michaelis and Menten derive an equation from which we can calculate the KM value, that is, binding affinity of an enzyme to its substrate. Similarly, Rosenthal-Scatchard derive an equation from which we can deduce the binding affinity of a receptor for its ligand. The receptor also acts as an enzyme and gets saturated upon increase in ligand concentration, just like the enzyme gets saturated with increase in substrate concentration. So coming to the main points, we know that receptor binds with the ligand to form a receptor-ligand complex. And the equilibrium constant for this equation is known as association constant, that is Ka. Association constant is just the inverse of dissociation constant, which is denoted by Kd. So association constant is equals to the product concentration, that is receptor-ligand complex divided by reactant concentration, that is receptor and ligand concentration. If we talk about the equilibrium, so at the equilibrium, the total receptor concentration, that is RT, is equal to the free receptors and the receptors which are bound to the ligand, that is RL complex. So free receptor is equal to the total receptor minus receptor bound with the ligand. Putting this value of free receptor in our first equation of association constant, we get Ka is equal to receptor ligand concentration divided by total receptor concentration minus receptor ligand complex concentration multiplied by free ligand concentration. Therefore, the ratio of RL complex to free ligand is Ka multiplied by total receptor concentration minus receptor ligand complex. So friend, this is the Scatchard equation for receptor and ligand binding interaction. And we can use this equation to plot a graph as follows. We will use the RL upon L ratio in the x-axis. K is the slope and this negative sign is indicative of a negative exponential graph. RT is plotted on the x-intercept and RL is on the x-axis. So now we have derived the Scatchard equation and also the Scatchard plot. But the question is how we can interpret this plot. So to understand this, let us study different cases of varying ligand concentration with fixed amount of receptor concentration. So in case number one, there is total four ligand molecule, all of which have bound to the receptor. Actually, we are assuming that the receptor has high affinity for the ligand. So the ligand first saturates the receptor, and if excess molecules are present, then these comes into the solution. So for the y-axis, we can calculate the RL upon L value. The receptor ligand complex is 4 and there is no free ligand, so that value is 0. That comes to be infinity, or we can say that it is maximum value. And for the x-axis, the receptor ligand complex is 4. So the plot for these values is like this, where the slope is quite high. Coming to the case number 2, where ligand concentration is very high and the receptor has also been saturated. So for the y-axis, RL upon L is equal to 4 upon 8. 4 is the receptor ligand complex and 8 is the free ligand concentration, which is the 8. This value comes to be 0.5, and on the x-axis there is 4. So in this case the slope decreases. So we can conclude that if receptor has high affinity for ligand, the slope is high initially but decreases as the ligand concentration increases. Now let us discuss the Scatchard plot for receptor which have low binding affinity for its ligand. So in this case number 3, there are 6 ligands, but due to the low affinity of receptor, only 2 forms receptor ligand complex and the 4 remains in the solution, giving y is equal to 0.5 and the value of RL on the x-axis is 2. So the plot of this values is like this, where the slope is quite low. Let us also check one more example. In this case, only one ligand has bound to the receptor and three are present in the soluble form. So the value on the y-axis is 0.33 and on the x-axis is 1, giving a very less value of slope. So we can conclude that if the receptor has low affinity for its ligand, slope will remain low. That is always less than 1. But in the case of high affinity receptors, the receptor gets saturated at high ligand concentration. The slope is quite high and then decreases with an increase in ligand concentration. So I think, friend, you must have benefited from this tutorial of Scatchard plot. Thank you for watching this video and stay with us for more videos. Thank you.